Well, hi, welcome to another edition of Your Schools. I'm Guy Sconzo, the very proud superintendent of Humble ISD. With me, thank goodness, is Lynn Fields, the absolutely bestest co-host ever. Lynn, it's great to see you, and it's summer.
You look so much more relaxed
it,
now.
It feels a little better now that we've made it to summer, and you know, but we're gearing up.
That's right.
We're going to blink, and we'll be back for another new school year. But Lynn, we've got great stuff to share with all of you on the show today, really highlighting many of our students.
You know, one of the segments that we're going to be doing shows character and academics and athletics in a program at Humble High School that I think is a wonderful program.
Yeah, it really is very special. You're all going to want to learn more about that. Also, our AVID program at Timberwood Middle School earned a significant national honor, and we're really thrilled about that.
That's right, and they spent 18 months doing it, so you have to hear what they did. And then science fair. It's always fun to talk to these kids and realize how stupid we really are. These kids are amazing, so you want to hear it.
I think aging and stupidity, there may be some kind of a correlation there.
Maybe, I don't know.
But we're big on science, and so yes, we're going to talk about science fair. We're also going to share with you a very special science program at all of our middle schools that really you'll want to learn more about. So, thanks for joining us. Enjoy the beginning of summer, and enjoy and stay with us, because we've got some great segments to share with you. We'll be right back. Well, thanks for coming back. And Lynn, we are so excited. You know, Timberwood Middle School, one of the eight middle schools in Humble ISD, has long been involved and really our pioneer in being involved with an AVID program. And AVID stands for Advancement Via Individual Determination. Really is all about preparing and supporting students for highly rigorous and advanced coursework, and giving students all the tools that are necessary to be successful in that coursework. Well, as if we weren't already very proud of Timberwood and what they were doing with and for our students, this past year they were identified by the National AVID Organization as a National Demonstration School for AVID. Now that means that people from educators from all over the country, literally, come to Timberwood Middle School to see how it's done and how it needs to be done in order to be successful for kids. So we are so delighted to share with you the principal of Timberwood Middle School, Ken Buck. Ken, it is good to see you.
Thank you.
Renee Herbst is next to Ken, and Renee is an AVID teacher at Timberwood, but more importantly, she coordinates the entire AVID program. Renee, it's great to see you. By the way, you guys, I love the shirts.
Thank you.
You have to get one of those.
I think those are sharp looking.
They are sharp. And last but certainly not least, an eighth grader at Timberwood, and Christian Broussard. And Christian, you are an AVID student.
Yes.
So we're going to want to get to you in just a second. But Ken, why don't you start by just giving us a quick overview of what AVID has meant to Timberwood and the designation as a demonstration school.
Well, really, for what it really means for Timberwood is it allows us to build teacher capacity and give those teachers the strategies to help increase that rigor and also improve student achievement as well.
Well, Renee, this was an 18-month application process, and we kind of joked a little bit earlier about like giving birth to two children.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about the process, how, you know, what the application was like and what the evaluation was like to get here.
Well, when we started AVID, we knew that we wanted to do it to the fullest. We wanted to dot those I's and cross those T's and do it with fidelity. We had a director that always said, if we're going to do it, we're going to do it right. So starting with our sixth graders coming in, we started with making sure that they were in the pre-AP math. And that was the big key, because we had to have 50 to 70% of our eighth graders taking Algebra 1. So we had to build that, and that took that 18 months. And then we also had to prepare our students to get into more pre-AP courses, because the more pre-AP courses that you take, the more successful they're going to be in high school. And research shows that in high school, the more they take there, the more successful they are in college.
Got it. Good job.
So, Christian, you've been an Avid.
Yes, sir.
And you are right on the verge of starting high school. So I know that Avid really is about preparing you not only for high school, but after high school as well. So talk to us about your plans for high school and if there are any plans after high school.
Well, my plans in high school is, well, I'm taking two pre-AP classes, World Geography pre-AP and biology pre-AP, and I'm also doing football, and in the future I am doing choir in high school, and I plan on achieving my next goals I set, and in college I plan on going to whatever school accepts me first. And
well, great. And you play football, too.
Yes, sir.
Awesome.
So I think that's pretty obvious looking at Christian that he's a football player, right?
Well, Christian, we've got to talk about Texas A&M at some point, but we'll do that later.
He will start talking to you about being an Aggie, so never fear. Well, Ken, you know, back when I was in middle school, we really didn't even think about the future and what was going to happen mm-hmm. when we got out of school. We were still living in, you know, for the moment. How has the shift, the cultural shift, changed for Timberwood and other middle schools through a program like Avid, where you're focusing kids on what they may want to do in their futures?
Well, it certainly didn't happen overnight. And we purposely set some things up to make sure that our students are aware of what their post-secondary opportunities are. And then we went over and did some things intentionally. We did pennants. We mailed off, sent out letters to different universities. Our students wrote the letters. And, you know, Timberwood's middle school is a college readiness campus. We'd love to have one of your pennants hanging in the hallway. And we have hundreds of pennants in our hallway. In fact, we have visitors come in for volleyball and basketball games from other schools, and are looking, trying to find their college. Mm-hmm. In fact, I was telling Dr. Sconzo the other day that a girl that was walking down the hall, and she looked like she was doing a vertical jump. She was jumping up on the wall and slapping a pennant. I was like, what are you doing? And she said, that's the college I'm going to. And it was an A&M pennant, so.
Don't you feel happy?
But we also do some other things, too. Last year, we took every sixth grader to a college campus. That's including life skills, applied skills. Every sixth grader went to a college campus. Wow. This year, we opened up a college and career corner that has the technology to let students go in and determine where they want to go, what career choices, you know, what a career may pay, what certification, what degree they may have, so they can start planning now.
That's amazing. And how exciting for students at that age to be able to, I guess, be taken as an adult. You know, we're preparing you for your future. We know, you know, middle school is such a transitional age that it really helps mature them, I would think.
You know, it is such an amazing culture at Timberwood that truly you all have created, and Christian, you as well. I mean, when I'm on that campus, it doesn't feel like a middle school.
Right.
It really doesn't. Folks are real serious about their work. Folks are happy about their work. It's, cannot commend you enough for truly the culture that you've created there. Renee, they're waving us on, which I hate, but I'm going to ignore them for just a second, because you really have enjoyed the benefit, in my opinion, hands-on, of just seeing what happens to an incoming sixth grader at Timberwood in Avid, and what that sixth grader looks like and is doing as an eighth grader. So
yes,
describe what the changes you've seen.
It gets very teary-eyed when that eighth grader leaves, because we do become an Avid family. We really do. And when those sixth graders come in, they're like lost little babies. And after 6 weeks or so, I mean, they're doing things like GPA contest. I mean, they're talking mm-hmm. GPA. Mm-hmm. You know, why aren't you making a C in that class? Come on now, you got to get on board. And they're organizing. They're starting to become successful, and they're starting to become confident.
Yeah.
And so, because every week they do speeches, they do presentations during their college tutorials. We have college tutors that come on campus, and they have to present every week. So they have to present and learn those speaking skills. Mm-hmm. So they become those leaders. And so by the time they leave for in eighth grade, I know they're ready for high school.
So Christian, You ready for high school and college already?
Yes,
you just can't wait to get started, I'll bet.
Yes, ma'am. But I'm going to miss all my 8th grade teachers.
Oh, I know they're going to miss you, too.
Absolutely.
Just know, teachers always keep up with their students, so they will know how you're doing, and they'll be wishing you well all along the way.
And you go out of your way to go visit every now and then, too.
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you all for being with us. And again, congratulations. National Demonstration School for AVID. That's a huge achievement, and we could not be more proud of you and grateful to all that you do.
Thank
you all stay with us. Lynn and I will be right back, and we've got another great story to share with you.